हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम बैक टू मरीना के किस चैनल। आई होप यू ऑल आर हैविंग अ गुड डे। सो फ्रेंड्स, डू यू वांट टू टेक स्पॉन्सरशिप ऑफ एससीआई, आई मीन शिपिंग कॉर्पोरेशन ऑफ इंडिया फॉर डीएनएस कोर्स? बट डू यू नो व्हाट काइंड ऑफ वेसल्स दे हैव एंड हाउ शुड यू अप्रोच फॉर द स्पॉन्सरशिप व्हेन दे रिलीज देयर एप्लीकेशन फॉर्म्स एंड वेदर दे विल टेक यू एज थर्ड ऑफिसर आफ्टर योर 18 मंथ्स ट्रेनिंग पीरियड इज ओवर और नॉट? इफ यू वॉन्ट ऑल दिस इन्फॉर्मेशन देन येस, you are at the exact right place. I am going to give you all the information in this video. Stick to this video till end and have benefits of all the information. And yes, one more thing guys, if you are new to my channel, then subscribe to my channel, tap the bell icon so that you get notified at the exact right time when I upload any kind of informational videos. And yes, the very important thing that you must check the DNS section in the playlist of my channel. There you will get information about Anglo-Eastern, Great Eastern and many informations and questions. I have given answer to many questions about what are the interview questions, what are the other information, how should you approach for Great Eastern, how should you approach for Anglo-Eastern. You will get the playlist section in the end of this video also. From end of this video, you can easily get access to the playlist. Watch the playlist, you will get all the information. And yes, at the end of this video, I am going to give you some good information and instructions which is very important for you. So stick to this video till end and let's start the video. Starting from obviously eligibility criteria, at first educational qualification. See, the minimum educational qualification required for DNS sponsorship and that also for SCI or for any company in India in Merchant Navy is class 12. So the candidate must be passed in class 12 and his or her marks should not be less than 60%. If you have 59.5%, then let me tell you that strictly you are not eligible. And if you have given your exams and your result is not yet published, then still you are eligible to apply for the sponsorship. But while admission, they will check whether you have marks more than 60% or not. If you have more than 60%, then yes, you are eligible. In case that you know how was your exam and you think that you will not be able to score more than 60% but still you are applying, then it's a waste of money and time. Please don't do that. And yes, you can apply after graduation and BE also. So if you have completed your graduation, I mean if you have completed your BSc in PCM or you have done BSc in electronics with physics as one of the individual subject, then still you are eligible, but the college should be recognized and your marks should not be less than 60%. If you have completed your degree course, I mean if you have completed BE or BTech from a recognized AICTE college, then still you are eligible, but your marks should not be less than 50%. And yes, one more thing guys, for ST and SC there is 5% relaxation in educational qualification and that also in marks, which does not apply on English marks because the requirement for English is whether in class 12, in graduation or in degree course, your marks should be 50% or more than 50%. It's not at all compulsory that in all these categories, like you have completed your class 12 and you have completed your graduation, then they will check either in class 12 or graduation. In any of these qualifications, if you have 50% or more than 50% in English, then you are eligible. Now, age limit. The maximum age limit for general category student is 25, but a candidate who belongs to STSC category will get a relaxation of 5 years. That means if you belong to STSC category, you can apply for sponsorship till 30 years of age. Now, medical standard. See, your eyesight should be perfect, that means 6x6. No color blindness will be accepted, or in case if you have any other defects in your eyesight, then you are still not eligible. Your height should not be less than 157 cm. But if you belong to hilly or tribal areas, then according to DGS or government guidelines, you have a relaxation. So you have to tell this thing to the DGS shipping approved doctor whom you are meeting for your medicals. And your hearing should be perfect, because at the time of medical you will have to go through a hearing test which will tell you whether your both the ears are perfect in hearing or not. See, as I have told you guys earlier that SCI is Shipping Corporation of India. If you get the sponsorship of SCI, then you will have to complete your DNS course from MTI, which is a residential course. I mean, you will have to stay in hostel. That's why we call it residential course. So MTI is Maritime Training Institute, which is in Powai. MTI is affiliated under IMU, which is Indian Maritime University. And for this reason, you will have to crack IMU CET. Otherwise, you will not get your name on the merit list. So IMU CET, I have already made videos on IMU CET. You can watch that and see. For this sponsorship, you will have to fill up two different application forms. Number one is IMU CET and number two is application form of SCI. Both are different forms. You will have to fill both the forms. And IMU CET form, they have a particular time. They will release it. And after IMU CET form gets released, SCI releases it form. The cost of form is zero. They don't take any money. And one more thing, you will have to crack only IMU CET. They will release a merit list, yes, and they don't take any test, they don't take any interview, so you don't have to worry about that. It's a good thing of SCI because, you know, SCI is Shipping Corporation of India, it's a government, so it won't provide you a government job, but still they are not taking any interview or test. And if you talk about passport, then yes, they will ask you for original passport to show it before admission. Otherwise, your admission might get cancelled or they might tell you that you don't have any passport, because it's already mentioned in their website that if you want to take admission, you will have to show the original passport before confirming your admission. So if you have 15 to 20 days, then I would suggest you or take it as advice that go for Tatkal passport. Don't go for that 1 month or 1.5 months passport. I mean normal passport that surely will waste your 1 month, 1.5 month. Go for Tatkal. Yes, it takes a little bit more money, but you will definitely get your passport within a week, within 15 to maximum 20 days. Now, fees of DNS course is 6.5 lakhs to 7 lakhs. And for loan facility, they don't provide any loan, but yes, you can approach other banks. I mean, for there are many banks that provide loans for educational purpose. You can contact them, but yes, every college will provide you the papers required for loan facility. Basically, there are two batches. One is for August 1, one is for Feb batch. For both the batch, you will have to crack IMU CET. And if you talk about seats, minimum intake of both the batches is 40. And the maximum depends upon their requirement, upon their vacancy. Sometimes they take 80, sometimes they take only 40. So the minimum is fixed, which is 40. But the maximum is not fixed, so it basically depends upon them. It's already kind of mentioned in their website that our minimum is 40 and maximum we can change it anytime according to our requirements. Now you have all the general information about MTI college, you know all the information about SCI, you know what are the loan procedures, whether they will give you the exact loan or not, you know what are the relaxations for STSC candidate. Now the very important topic, which is how should be your approach for the sponsorship. In simple words, if I say, how should you apply? First, very first thing, visit www.imu.edu.in. Fill up the IMU CET application form. After IMU CET application form gets released, SCI releases their application form. Fill SCI form. As I said earlier, both are different forms. You'll have to fill up both the forms. And after filling up the IMU CET form, fill up the SCI form. After filling up both the forms, you'll have to send self-attested scanned copies of 6 documents to SCI. And what are the 6 documents? I'm going to tell you. Kindly note it or you can record it. Very first thing, class 10th marks certificate or pass certificate, class 12th marks certificate or pass certificate, school leaving certificate or TC, and a caste certificate. If you are STSC or OBC, you will have to show them. You should have the caste certificate. Otherwise, please don't fill up the caste in the application form. And then you'll have to give them the copy of IMU registration slip and at last signature, I mean scanned copy of your signature and your photo. So these are the 6 documents. Kindly arrange all the 6 documents before applying or keep the record of all the signatures. And the kind of size of the scanned copies is 5 MB or 6 MB. Try to keep the size of that scanned copies below this, otherwise they will reject or otherwise it basically creates a problem for you. And try to provide them all these scanned copies via mail, or if they are not responding to your mail, then kindly contact them once. Now the very most important topics, it's important for all you guys, is that how will be your career after completing your DNS course with SCI sponsorship and from MTI Powai. See, it's a general question, and a very general answer to that is you will be having SCI sponsorship. That means after completing your DNS course, you will be working on their vessels. They have tankers, they have bulk carriers, they have break bulks, they have container ships, they have coastal passenger services, coastal services, they have break bulk services, they have a variety of vessels. Don't worry for that on which vessel they will send you, it's afterwards. Keep the attention for afterwards, at least focus on completing your course. And after completing your 18 months course, you will be eligible for second mate COC. After clearing second mate COC, at first you will be working as third officer, and after 3 to 4 contracts, see, basically the requirement to get promoted as second officer depends on individual companies. Some promote after 2 contracts, some promote after 4 contracts. So they might promote you on board, or they might promote you at first, and then they will give you contract as second officer. And at the end, I would like to give you a very important instruction that I talked to you guys about in the very beginning of this video, that if you have the sponsorship of SCI, that means SCI is bound to complete your 18 months training period. After that, it is not at all compulsory, and please don't take it wrong that they will give you job. It totally depends upon them. They are giving sponsorship, that means anyhow they will have to make sure that the sponsored candidate has completed its 18 months training period. And after that, as I said earlier, that you will be giving second mate COC, you will become third officer. So according to their vacancy, they might give you job or they might not give you job. It totally depends upon them. You can't do anything of that. So it's a very rare question that I am going to get sponsorship of SCI, so they will give me job after training period is over or not, or they will call me as third officer. None of the company will call you. I mean, they might call you or they might not call you. It totally depends upon them. If they are giving you sponsorship, that means they are bound to make sure that your whole 18 months training period is over. So these were all the information. It is very necessary for you to have all the information before choosing your career or before choosing any college or any sponsorship company for your career. And yes, don't forget to comment down how the video was, and please drop a like. It makes me happy, a little bit happy. And yes, don't even forget to subscribe and share, because please support your subscribe and support your one subscription makes me support. I mean, I feel supportive. And yes, do follow me on Instagram for updates. My user ID is MarinaKK. You will get the link in the description also. And in case if you have any general questions or queries, we'll get the link in description. You can click on it, you can follow that space, you can drop your questions. I will definitely answer that. And till that time, stay good, stay fit. Thank you for watching, guys.